Hello, this is team 67101C, and this is our highly anticipated string shooter explanation video.
It was fully capable of covering all of the tiles, and in one of our skills runs at Haunted, it managed to get 26 tiles or 78 points.
So we have the linear slide as our main mechanism here, and then we have these little inserts with the lock bars and screws are what we're actually firing across the field. So the first part of the system is the release. That's this three long C channel, which is mounted on a screw joint. It's got proper bracings, that's 7/8 of an inch worth of spacers. And then we use a caps nut there so that we can mount a cantilever without the additional support. And then this would be connected to a cylinder, which we ended up having to take off due to limited resources and our rebuild. It would move up and down. So, as you see, this would be down when the cylinder is down, and then when the cylinder moves up, that latch is what moves up. So then, in order to actually load this string shooter projectile, we have a rubber band on the bottom. You can see there it's held in by a 5-long 1/2, and then we have some spacers in there, and those spacers are a bit further back just because we needed a bit more tension on this specific launcher. So then when you load it, kind of hold it back there, and you just push back until this thing latches into place. Now, one thing we have to tune very closely on each of these launchers is that screw head right there. You have to have it unscrewed just by a little bit so that it'll catch on that latch. If you unscrew it too much, then it won't actually release, but if you don't have it screwed in enough, then it'll prematurely fire. And yeah, there's nothing fancy with how we mounted this. We just kind of slapped it on using a gusset. It doesn't have to be super securely mounted or anything like that. So then this is held in here. Now, the other part here is our string. We used some yarn just from Hobby Lobby. Now, keep in mind that after the game manual update in early November, this is no longer competition legal string, as it is not 1/8 of an inch thick. But this is what we used for our haunted robot, and it was legal at the time. So this is how we store the string. Then to fire it, we'd pull it off of that 2-inch C channel and onto the 3-inch long C channel, and then just kind of have it hanging there. And since it's at an angle, it's not going to fall off at all during the match. But then when this gets pulled up, so then the way that we would rewind this string is we had a quick swap system. So we just have a flat nut held in at the middle, super easy to take off. And then the entire system can just come right off here. So we could have multiple of these for a robot if we wanted to. And it's just a 7-long 1/2 with the standoffs. And then to wind the string up,
we take it, you have to leave it on the 3-lied first. And then you can just screw it back in. So yeah, nothing super fancy, and it's not really that sturdy, but it didn't have to be. We didn't have any issues with this being loose or anything. So yeah, that's pretty much our entire endgame. And then we just would have a launcher there, another one there, another one there, another one there, and there used to be another one there.
So here are some more pictures of the endgame when it was fully assembled, and we have lots of videos of the robot in action elsewhere on the channel, And if there aren't already, there should be some videos coming out of our new endgame and new robot.
The amount of times that Mr. Grubbs